2012. Codemaster. Yo. It was for them whom this and that people crawled
cool.
up like
so we have flat. Gathered this here today for round 5. Pro League. Quite a few were absent today, so we're gonna start the race with 11 drivers today. And hopefully what will be a sunny Grand Prix, but I don't know how much praise has been dancing this week. Knowing him, he'll been running around in his white undies for quite a while. So in the neighborhood. Well, qualifying at least. Starting off dry, it seems. I actually have a teammate this time around.
The gear from my brakes, 60 kilowatt, the sound that it makes, 100 megawatt, me step on the brake, 1000 megahertz, me lay them out flat, me
ooh, 100% chance, flat. He is dancing very, very well.
60 kilowatt, the sound that it makes, 100 megawatt,
100% chance of rain.
1000 megahertz, me lay them out flat, me lay them out flat, the gear from my brakes, 60 kilowatt, the sound that it makes, 100 megawatt,
right hand, 2 and 2, sure, like 5 on 5, 2 arms,
me lay them out flat, me lay them out flat.
Ooh, close maximums of the disconnect, what the fuck? That was quick.
It happens.
It does, unfortunately. Happened to Senti all the time, that's why he decided to step out eventually.
Too much. Into Bird Jungle's last race.
Yep.
There's only 11 of us, so we might be in some chance, some points.
These will be allowed if there are like 9 less than 10 finishes. We will be allowed to spend it for sprint race. Yeah.
Come on, rerun.
See if I can go as fast as I was able to do in practice. Blast all my curves going on to the straight. 121.34. Not bad. See if Lewis can find his way back in. We'll be starting from last, but at least he'll be in the race. Well, was on the 4/10 improvement on my lap, but I made a little mistake. I hope it's not one of those races where it just starts wet for a couple of laps and then that's it, you know?
Yeah.
And that's just annoying.
Yeah, I want a little bit more excitement. So a good half the race rain would be good.
Just to be, just be consistent. Now I can get in the 120s, I think. In the 123 in practice with Price nearly in the week, of course, usually never that fast when the actual event starts. My luck and all. Oh, it's snowing now, mate, over here. It has arrived. Good night in Catalunya over here outside my window. Price probably going, Snow, what the fuck's that?
Yeah. That's the stuff that's on top of mountains.
We ain't never heard about that around here. When I'm wrestling with my crocodiles. Sorry. Making Steve Irwin jokes again. Rough ones anyway.
They're a bit.
I'm usually not a one lap wonder. We got that. It's really not paying attention. Really so high up the car.
Down the order, you're currently in fourth.
quick. I can move around it. No time for another run. Because again, I never go as fast doing an actual event that I would do in practice, obviously.
That fan sound, whoever it is terrible.
Yes, why?
What's that?
Some fucked up noises coming from your end, mate. Alright, let's see. What I mean. Glues had a disconnection, Steam got like kicked off. There's another bloody thing I can do. Once he's actually out. Oh, look at the times between number 1 and 2. Like, less than a hundredth of a second between them. 1.99.00, then a 1.99.09, then a 1.99.44 by Isofab. Top three guys are really, really close together. I think Amin is hoping for rain at the start because he's already in lap 5. And he's blowing through tyres. Uh-huh. And the session is now over. Everybody on the lap is on the lap. And that will be it. See what I mean? Wrecking his tires, sure. Missed the chicane a little bit. And he's going into the pit lane. And Drome is on the help lap. A little bit of wide. Shouldn't cost too much. Bit wide on the hairpin. Bit wide on the exit. Oh, he uses the DRS there. And he lost it. And hits the barrier. Ooh, there goes his wing. And there goes my teammate. And he also goes in the pit lane, so nobody is going for a quicker time. And that's it. Our new competitor is into pole position. Amin second, Isofab third, Rain, Priest, Palindrome, myself in seventh. I think that's my best qualifying ever so far. Then Kevin Porrot, Sly in ninth, Osborne, and then Glutus is registered at the bottom, but he got kicked out of the session. So we'll be starting with 10 cars, so you just have to go over the line and you'll have a point regardless.
Sly, that fan or whatever it is.
It's fucking annoying here. And it starts not off top dread wet. I hope these changes I've made will provide me a bit of better grip. It looks like it says intermediate weather.
Hey.
It'd be interesting to take a gamble on wet or not.
First two turns are going to be fun.
Yeah, that's true.
I'd take a set of intermediates in these unpredictable conditions.
As for car setup, I don't really give a shit at the moment. It's just winging its time, basically. Tim's of fuel, that is. More tire choice. Alright, I'm ready to go myself.
Alright.
Yeah, I haven't pressed go yet, I'm just waiting here.
What is that noise coming from your end, Sly?
I ain't got a clue, mate.
Yeah, I'm actually really pondering if I should like start on wets and see what happens. Be a nice gamble if it pays off. Maybe I should just go more traditional. The wet, and let's just go. Alright, I'm ready to press go here. 30 seconds, not much changes you can make anyway.
Nah, let's do it.
In terms of car setup, it's just a winging it day anyway when rain's involved.
I'm glad I'm starting at the back.
Hmm?
I'm glad I'm starting at the back.
Mm-hmm. Gives you all the chance to run into me now. I think you're right behind me. I'm probably braking a little bit earlier for the first corner. Just hopefully to avoid everything that's going to happen in front of me. Or well, there's a big chance of happening in front of me.
Oh, good luck, everyone.
All right.
Good luck. Enjoy yourselves, boys.
Alright. Try not I'll to try. Die. Everybody's safely off the line, it seems.
Oh, I got a penalty for that. You're joking.
I got hit by palindrome.
I was just smashed in the side.
Really do
I
anything
got
about it?
For that.
Sounds familiar. To me once. Well, Discovery's pole position is long gone. He's dropping all the way back.
Up into fifth, and I've got a penalty to serve. That's not good.
Are you already in first place?
No.
How? How did that happen?
Oh dear.
We expect the rain to stop in the next couple of laps.
Oh, it's worse. It's heavy.
At least I improve. Palindrome just spun behind me. Driving so carefully and still I slide all over the place. Great passing move, he was off the track. Look at that top three over there, or at least a group of three cars. At least the top three.
Losing too much time.
Right, so now the game has begun. Still a bit slippery.
The car behind is running on a prime tyre. We should try and create a gap. Pace is good.
Oh, what the fuck is all? Why the fuck does that always happen to me? No reason to really go, but it will fucking go anyway. Probably because I'm a millimeter too much on the throttle. Position back to palindrome, isn't really quite far over take. Might force him wide. Much better exit now. Position are you in now, Sly? After that?
No, I was the first one to come in on to put slicks on. So I made up myself good 15 seconds, I think, a couple laps.
Alright, good job. God fucking shit! Whole car! Why? Oh my god. And now I can fucking start all over again. Why is it suddenly so much more unstable? I never fucking get it. You can practice, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. And then in race. Oh, you wanted grip? You're not getting it. Fuck off. Fucking car. So fucking aggravated. Which doesn't make driving easy. Rip, where has thy disappeared to? The Ferrari jeans are suddenly spilling over into this final race now for some reason. Again? Fucking Jesus! What is wrong with this car all of a sudden? It's that fucking chicane at the end all of a sudden that's giving me loads of trouble. Never gave me any shit during qualifying and practice, but now all over the fucking place over there. Oh yeah, of course, you gotta do that now. I have no idea what is wrong with this car all of a sudden in terms of grip. I love it how practice, for some reason, in multiplayer, does not resemble the car in any way right now. Fucking ruined thanks to the car. Biffy. Basically lost confidence in the car. So. For some reason it's completely shit in that stadium section now. God, fuck it again! That was maybe too much curb. Jesus Christ. All the grip that I had in the stadium section with these small rain adjustments is fucking gone. I blame the snow outside.
Blame it on who, mate?
So I'm blaming me down on the snow outside. So pretty. I still got my concentration. Even though I haven't looked outside once yet. It's very
sunny. He's too busy dreaming about building a snowman later.
Yep. I'm wishing him for him to come to life. Just because of all of the mistakes, I'm from 6th down into 8th, 8 seconds behind. Gaining on Poro again, that's a good sign at least. How are you doing, Price?
Second, but under very heavy pressure from Isofab.
Good fun then, I guess.
So I'm going to end in tears, so I called it, scrap it. Ay, ay, ay.
We knocked you off?
No, it was only going to end in tears. Such close racing that, I got to get out some fresh rubber. Thank you.
preparing for a pit stop. We're ready for you. Box in this lap.
You're 128? Oh man, that's so much time.
Okay, prime for your next box.
I don't know what it is with this car all of a sudden.
Exit now.
I don't drive it well at all.
I got exactly the same lap time.
Nice. Well, that's a plus for consistency. The shitty thing is, like, I adjusted my car for rain again, and it only, like, stayed there for a fucking couple of laps. And I'm suffering for the rest of the race, basically. Now the primes are certainly working better than the options were. Even though in practice it was just exactly the other way around. at that group of three cars, holy shit. No, don't do that, you stupid Ferrari. Don't conform to the stereotype.
Rain just had a screen freeze.
Got any goddamn consistent laps with this car. Times are slightly improving now. Second time now. Did that happen straight after? Fastest lap, that's good. That is good. Are you good for the sector again? Left front is going significantly faster than everything else. I keep this pace up, I'm slowly catching. Poro. stupid risks in the chicane that are simply not worth it. Right, I'm getting back into the groove. I'm slowly eating away. Cav on now. He's a very consistent driver, he doesn't make a lot of mistakes. So then let's do the same.
And then me. Is that you behind me, Bruce?
Yes, it is.
Oh, mate, I'll let you pass along the straight down the corner. I'm going to the left.
Oh, I had a little moment. Keep going, keep going.
Using the lead at the moment, Amin.
Yep.
Are you still three together, or is this just...
No, he's on his own.
Oh, I've only got a penalty.
Another point.
I've got another penalty.
Like blue flags or something.
I'm gonna pull up to the right.
Thank you.
For ignoring blue flags or something.
Yeah.
Oh, lovely.
But it's only because Priest lost it at the corner, so he backs off a bit. But they're still waving blue flags at me. Even though he was right, you know, way behind.
Lovely.
I will.
Another props for Cape Masters.
Oh. No, just go around, don't worry about it.
Oh, you're already serving it, seeing how my teammate is, half a minute behind me. Significant gap to me, 7 seconds.
Alright, so I've got a race for 9th place, I think. This is what this is all about.
Thank you. So far, having more fun driving the car on prime tires than I am on the options. Practice it. No, no, no! Of course, that happens right when I say it. typical luck for me. I go off the track and of course lose probably 2-3 seconds again to Kevon. Nice, yep, back to 8 fucking seconds. Fucking shit. I always have that kind of luck, yeah. I say like, oh yeah, I'm doing alright. Fuck. That's all, yeah. Spin.
Well, at least someone didn't crash into you and give you a penalty at the start.
Start all over again. Trying on that. Jesus, that left front is going so fast. What the fuck? It's worrisome. Let's see that happen in practice again.
We would have been in the. Me and Priest would have been in a good position as well. Fourth and fifth at the time. So I could have slowed everyone else up behind me. They could have tore off.
Well, we would have probably had a good fight with Amin then, at the point.
Oh well. I'm gaining.
Like it's so annoying, so at least so disappointing. Now, you've been working for that gap for like 10 laps and like one little mistake and you're back to where you started. Such a shame, such a bloody fucking shame. This Kevon doesn't make any goddamn mistakes ever. It's not when it's dry. Very consistent with the driver. Suddenly found speed.
We need you to start lapping in the high minute 26 bracket to match the car ahead. Thank you.
You're not the only one having a slippery race pretender.
Well, that's one good thing to know. And if I can set a good pace, I mean, I'm catching Poro whenever I'm like in the groove, but then like something happens and I like drop 2 seconds again. So at the end of the race, I haven't gained shit, you know. Because I keep losing over silly little mistakes. I'm not catching him fast enough to be a real threat to him. At the end of it. My race is a little bit boring again. Basically finding myself more than I'm finding everybody else so far, apart from the first race. Quite be as consistent as you, Priest.
No, there's others more consistent than me.
Kevin made a little mistake. It's a rare mistake by him. Closes the gap a little. Where I had it before, I'm. So 6.5 seconds down, of course, but so at least shaves a second off. That was snowing quite heavily, actually. Change my braking balance. So I'm gonna feel low.
Went for the wrong setup strategy again. Went for the wrong strategy again.
What do you mean? Going in too soon or something?
No, I should have gone front end, more front end than rear end.
Seems poor I was suffering a little bit. Twenty-six laps left. That's too far for an option stint. And I'm in a groove. I don't really want to break. Second. I catching majorly on that middle sector on him. Too much.
We need a bit.
Half a second. Gap engineer. All right, another quickest personal best, or another personal best. My braking point a little bit. Too bad. You catching Osborne at all, Sly?
Yep.
Not quickly, or
about a second a lap, I think. Average.
Just out of curiosity, Trace, what kind of lap times are you driving, on average?
Mid-24s.
What is the pace then?
Funny you should say that, I'm way off the pace.
I'm driving 126, low 126s, or mid-126 now. And again, I am on the prime still. 3 seconds now, the gap between me and Kevon. Finally moving forwards again. Try to keep myself calm and not get too gritty or too hasty. Fall into those old mistakes again, as I did earlier. Throwing away all that earlier work. Stick to the old price tying. Nice and consistent. Not out of time again. Personal best. The most out of these tires. And see the back of Kevin's car a lot better now.
Ryan has a visit to the to the gravel trail.
And should give you a breather.
That's giving me a position, that's what it's done.
And then an immediate gap, so that's good.
Hey, I'm in 9.
Well done, mate.
Well done, Sly.
1.5 seconds away from Kevin now. Haven't had a proper fight in a while on the track. So hopefully I can make it a clean one. One more lap, I'm in the official gap for the option tires. Behind me. Oh, right, I'm in his DRS zone for the first time.
Someone going slow in a Williams.
I might have a meme by me.
Alright, Kevin made a mistake.
Next is one of the Lotus cars.
Oh, someone pitted. Alright, got the pass done. On Kevin. Got somebody else behind him. It's most likely Palindrome, I think. At least I would guess.
Okay, we need you to make way for
Palindrome's behind me.
So you're the leader, I mean.
Where is he?
He's now coming onto the main straight.
The pit crew are ready for
you. Full sector ahead.
Pit crew will ready option tyres for your next stop.
At a moment.
Where are you then?
Coming to the chicane right now.
Way behind. Then.
Yep.
We think the car behind is running on full revs. He's trying to.
Not enough of that goddamn rain.
I'm 8 seconds behind rain in the middle sector at the moment. And we're left up the hill. Discovery.
Remember to pit this lap.
Holy motherfucking Christ. It's a very, very aggressive fucking discovery. Just rear-ended me onto the chicane. And again.
Nice.
Be mindful of the car you're behind, Discovery.
Thank you.
Kevin Porro again. There's a small blizzard outside my window now. Almost. Dutch standards anywhere. Kevin is flying in those tires. Probably not inside DRS, would be fun if it is. Nope. Keeps me just outside the DRS.
Oi! Oi? Just ram me.
We're having a fun fight with Kevon at the moment.
Yeah, me and Osborne just coming for both pitted. So that's a flat out battle.
Yeah.
To the end.
There it is. Made a little mistake, so I got the DRS.
Rain in 15, the race will be over by then.
Yep.
Where were you during the race?
Slight.
Lost about 5 seconds now. Osborne.
We might need to think about moving to fuel mix mode 2 in the next few laps. You're gaining on him. Keep pushing.
Not close enough for a lunge. Kevin's got the DRS on me. He hasn't got the speed. Go 1-1 wing. My heart racing a little bit now with this good fight.
Someone's gone off.
So Kevon. That was probably Bojang of the palindrome. Yeah, that was Kevon went off. Shit, snowing like mad. You're like behind me, Sly or something. Is it Osborne? That's him, mate.
No, it's Osborne and then I'm behind Osborne.
I'm dragging my teammate along.
Thank you.
Oh, it was a good battle with Poro though.
Weather report suggests light rain in approximately 10 minutes.
Yeah, the rain's not going to get here on time. Thank God.
No, it won't.
It's the last thing I'm looking for.
There's the same situation in a practice race.
And the rain there. Is keeping up with me nicely. Pulling him along away from you. And DRS. Not even driving slowly or anything. One being smart, stays behind me. Using my toe. Seems like Discovery has found its base again. I'll buy it a bit too late, I reckon. Some of that quarter and fourth. This race. I'm done it in qualifying. Alright, sorry Osborne, you're on your own. Can't exactly drive slow either. Wouldn't be very fair either if I just gave him a turn. three more laps for me, I reckon, because I don't think I've been a lap by a mean.
Got no DRS now.
Oh, lovely.
Just when I need it.
Well, he's got it on me as well.
There goes this race once.
No, oh, this should be my second to last lap, the penultimate lap. In correct terms. This is fun, actually. I'm really helping my teammate pull away from you.
Yeah.
I'm not necessarily doing it deliberately, that I'm just pushing so Kevon doesn't get a chance. There we go, and things he's dropped off.
Yeah, he's got more fuel than me. I'm on standard, he's on full.
I'm also on standard.
I don't stay with him, but I just can't get past him.
No, because I'm helping him on the straights.
And I've got no DRS either.
Yeah, that makes you will lose a lot. I'm dropping majorly away from Discovery. Right, this ought to be my last lap. Pretty sure. What's the meanest pit it? I'm pretty sure I still lapped. Yep. Struggle a lot with the car in the beginning. Probably lost a lot more, but had some good fun near the end, finishing in 7th.
That was an amazing salvage operation by me. Holy shit.
Second place anyway. Good job, mate. People still on track. Palindrome is in 4th. Well done, Palin. He profited from the mistakes Discovery has made throughout the opening stages of the race. I think he had a good tire strategy as well.
Not opening. He was right up there. He made correct for those mistakes that he did earlier. He was right up there. Later on, I don't know what happened. He just completely disappeared off the radar.
So yeah, damage
also in one lap. Oh, okay.
I think, oh well, that's my reckoning.
That was halfway through the race.
And there he goes.
And someone just smashed my visor.
Alright,
start.
Screenshots there. Amin has won. Price has become finished in second place. Ice Fab third, Palindrome a very good fourth, Rain fifth, Discovery, a new driver in the Pro League, is in sixth. I managed to get into seventh, where I started. Kevin Porro is in eighth. Osborne, also a new driver, finished ninth. And Sly has finished in 10th position. And there you go. So another tricky start for this race. And well, basically Sly's race, so I've heard, pretty much got fucked in the ass, so to speak.
Yeah, was you behind me on the start, was it, mate?
I didn't hit anybody.
No, I said, was you behind me? You got it on.
Yeah, I didn't. Yeah, you outbraked me. Palindrome has an incident to report already. Oh, you look all into all that. You should have that on camera.
Yep.
The Discovery at a moment with me as well. He bumped my rear, but he aggressively took me over after that. So, Sly, what exactly happened to you? I know I got bumped a little bit at the start.
Yeah, I got, drove straight on the side, and now I got a penalty for it.
Alright, so I'm going to stop the recording right here. Next week, it's the... it's going to be the Grand Prix of Grand Prix. The classic, the Monaco Grand Prix.
Oh, Discovery did what I did. Discovery did what I did in Australia. He put on inters on, in dry conditions.
Alright. So, everybody.
I thought that would happen.
I'm going to stop.